Hi, I'm Sharon Stanley, and I'm Chief Nurse for the American Red Cross. We've been getting a lot of questions lately about H1N1 influenza, or the swine flu. And I'd like to take this opportunity just to talk about the answers to some of those questions. With H1N1, what the hype is that it is a new, completely novel flu, and it's working its way across our world as termed a pandemic, or it's affecting the whole globe and certainly United States. Seasonal flu is a serious event in and of itself because we lose over 36,000 people to death in this country. Seasonal flu affects those 65 and older for the most part in terms of very serious complications, although a lot of us end up getting it if we don't get vaccinated. H1N1, though, is also impacting our population, but it is going across the entire spectrum in terms of serious effects in a way that we don't usually see with seasonal flu. That is, it's affecting young people and pregnant women and individuals who are young with chronic underlying conditions, for example, asthma or diabetes, in a way that seasonal flu really doesn't do. That's a hard thing to do because a case definition of influenza-like illness, or what means you might have H1N1, is a fever and a sore throat or a cough. So there's a lot of respiratory illness that produces fever and or sore throat and a cough. Right now in September, it's just H1N1 mostly circulating. But as we move into the fall, it's going to be H1N1 and seasonal flu. The important question, though, is what do you do about that in terms of staying home, protecting others around you if you get those symptoms? Also, what are you going to do for yourself? Regardless, if you think you've got influenza, you need to self-isolate and protect those around you. You need to be a good neighbor and a good family member. First of all, you want to make sure that you have enough food and water to last through the illness period, which will probably be a week at the least. The other thing you need to think about are the symptoms of H1N1, because once you have the disease, the virus, what you do is basically take care of the symptoms. So you need to think about, how do you reduce that fever? How do you take care of an upset stomach? What are you going to do for the cough? And how are you going to deal with a sore throat and muscle aches? So basically, go make yourself a to-go kit to take home so that you can stay there and be a good neighbor and a good caretaker for your family.